Hi, we're Ullalele and we're really happy to be taking part in Paul Briscoe's Otley Online Music Festival. I'm sure it's taken him a lot of time and effort to put everything together, but here we are.
And our first song is from our original ukulele version of The Time Machine by H.G. Wells, and it's The Time Traveller. Hope you enjoy it.
I'll tell you the story of what's happened to me if you like, but you must refrain from interruptions. Most of it will sound like lying, but it's true, every word. At 4 o'clock this afternoon, I was in my laboratory, and since then, I have lived for 8 days. 8 days as no human being has ever lived before. I'm worn out. But I shan't sleep, not until I've told this thing over to you. And then I shall go to bed. But there must be no interruptions. Is it agreed?
Agreed,
said the editor. And the rest of us echoed.
Agreed.
And with that, the time traveller began his story. Starting lever, I pushed and felt a nightmare sensation of falling and pressed the stop lever almost immediately. I looked around me at the laboratory. Everything appeared exactly as before. Then I noticed the clock. Just moments ago it had stood at a minute or so past 10. It now read 3:30. I drew breath and gripped the starting lever with both hands and pushed it to its extreme position. Night and day started to flash across the laboratory skylight with ever-increasing speed, not unlike the flapping of a great black wing, until day and night started to blur into a constant, greyish light. Presently my mind turned to the business of stopping. A peculiar risk lay in the possibility of some solid object occupying the same space which I occupied. I told myself I could never stop, and with a gust of petulance, I resolved to stop forthwith. This is Eloy, again from The Time Machine. machine slowed the passage of time, I looked around me. A large figure made of some white material loomed indistinctly through a hazy downpour. When the sensation of falling subsided, I saw the figure more distinctly. It was a white marble in the shape of a sphinx, with wings that were spread so that it seemed to hover. Then I heard voices approaching me. Coming through the bushes were men running. One of these emerged in front of me. He was a slight creature, perhaps 4 feet high, and he struck me as being very beautiful and graceful, but indescribably frail. Flowers and placed it round my neck. The idea was received with melodious applause, and they were all running to and fro for flowers and flinging them upon me laughingly until I was almost buried in blossom. Then the idea seemed to circulate that their new plaything should be exhibited in the nearest building, and I was led past the Sphinx of White Marble toward a great hall.
Many years of travel to paradise, it seems.
Hypertrophied raspberry and orange, but for the most part, they were strange. And between the tables were scattered a great number of cushions. Upon these we seated ourselves and began to eat. Fruit was all their diet. These people of the remote future were strict vegetarians, and indeed I learned later that horses, cattle, dogs and sheep had followed the ichthyosaurus into extinction. But the fruits were very delightful, and my hunger was quickly satisfied.
Our next song is from one of our occasional 80s sets, and this is Einstein a Go-Go by Landscape, not by Ullalele.
Einstein a Go-Go. Thank you.
amazing, wasn't it? Anyway, following that, we've got a piece from our War of the Worlds session, and this is Horsell Common and the Heat Ray. Don't get too warm.
Next morning, a crowd had gathered on the common, hypnotized by the unscrewing of the cylinder. 2 feet of shining screw projected, when suddenly, the lid fell off. 2 luminous disc-like eyes appeared above the rim, and a huge rounded bulk larger than a bear rose up slowly, glistening like wet leather. Its lipless mouth quivered and slathered, as its heaving tentacles writhed and pulsated.
rather enjoyed that. Our next song is Wiener from The Time Machine.
I walked about the hill looking for some trace of Wiener, but Wiener was gone. I saw Morlocks put their heads down in a kind of agony and rush into the flames, and at last, above the subsiding fire, above the black smoke and the blackening tree stumps, came the white light of the day.
Overpowered, a fight till we have won. In the moment I saw that you were gone. I see ghosts everywhere, driven to destruction by fire in the air.
I searched again for Wiener, but there was no sign. It was clear the Morlocks had left her poor little body in the forest, and I cannot describe how relieved I felt that she'd escaped the awful fate to which she had seemed destined.
See you cry, beautiful.
And so, leaving the remnant of these damned souls, I limped across the smoky ashes toward the hiding place of the time machine. I walked slowly and felt the intense wretchedness at the death of poor Wiener.
This next song is another Steamplunk original, based on a 19th century French sci-fi novel by Auguste Villiers de L'Isle Adam, and it's basically about this guy who built himself a clockwork girlfriend, so make of that what you will. Enjoy, it's called Hadalay.
And finally, here's the song that got Ullalele on its way and won the second place in the Ukulele of Band of Great Britain competition. Eve of the War, from War of the Worlds.
No one would have believed during the last years of the 19th century, that human affairs were being watched from the timeless worlds of space. No one could have dreamed that we were being scrutinized as someone with a microscope studies creatures that swarm and multiply in a drop of water. Few men even considered the possibility of life on other planets. And yet, across the gulf of space, Minds immeasurably superior to ours regarded this earth with envious eyes. And slowly and surely, they drew their plans against us. On the 12th of August, a huge mass of luminous gas erupted from Mars and sped towards Earth. Across 200 million miles of void, invisibly hurtling towards us, came the first of the missiles that was to bring so much calamity to Earth. As I watched, there was another jet of gas. There was another missile starting on its way. And that's how it was for the next 10 nights. A beautiful but disturbing sight. Ogilvy, the astronomer, assured me we're in no danger. He was convinced there could be no living thing on that remote, forbidding planet.
The chances of anything coming from Mars are a million to one, he said. The chances of anything coming from Mars are a million to one, but still they come.
Then came the night the first missile approached the Earth. It was thought to be an ordinary falling star, but the next day there was a huge crater in the middle of the common. Ogilvy went to examine what lay there, a cylinder 30 yards across and glowing hot, with faint sounds of movement coming from within. Suddenly the top began moving, rotating, unscrewing. Fearing there was a man inside, Ogilvy rushed to the cylinder, but the intense heat stopped him before he could burn himself on the metal.
The chances of anything coming from Mars
are a million to one, he said.
Just shows you that viruses aren't always bad.
See ya. Ta-ra.
Enjoy the end of the world.